Yo, so what's up, guys? We're going to be talking about the differences between Walmart automation and Amazon automation because they're two separate things, two separate platforms. One is better for certain things and the other is better for other things, but we're going to talk about that so you can make an informed decision on which one is right for you and why. Let's talk about it.
What's up, guys? This is Roughneck Actual, and you have reached the Roughnecks Ecom channel. If you want to learn how to make money online or offline, then you need to be right here. I'm a seven-figure Amazon seller. I'm also an honorably discharged Air Force veteran. Graduated from Penn State and started a career as a software engineer and leveraged that to build my businesses. If you guys have any questions on how to make money, you're going to find all your answers right here, so stay tuned.
Yo, all right, guys. Welcome back, Roughnecks. We are going to be talking about Walmart automation and Amazon automation. So I'm pretty sure you guys already know about Amazon automation, so we're going to save that for the latter half, okay? Walmart automation is the shiny new thing that everybody wants to get involved in. Everyone's marketing and all this crazy shenanigan stuff, and they're making it seem like it's the most amazing thing since sliced bread. But it is not without its challenges, okay? So before we even deep down, and I'm not going to endorse, you know, any Walmart automation service. I'm not going to be presenting it to anybody, at least for the next 6 months, because I don't feel that it's ready for prime time. But, you know, I have friends that do it. And, you know, if you guys follow me on social media, you can figure out who that is and they will offer it to you. I'm not going to offer it to you yet because I just don't feel that it's ready. You know, the Walmart platform is still growing, still really, really new. Now, the biggest benefit of Walmart automation right now is the fact that the margins are huge, man, huge. Like a fisherman telling you the story where he's like, yo, I caught a fish this big. That's pretty much what it is. Yo, the margins are this big in a lot of cases, okay? So let's just preface that right now. Walmart automation has crazy margins, but it's not without difficulty, okay? So that's the biggest benefit, is the fact that you can make a lot of money very quickly. But there's a lot more detriment than anything else, guys. You know, there's going to be a lot of people that will say, oh, but we can combat that and this and that. They haven't been selling long enough to know that shit. Okay, the average person hasn't been selling on Walmart longer than like 8 to 12 months at most. All right. And it takes a while to get approved even. Like in some cases, it could take you months. It took me damn near 3 months to get approved to sell on Amazon. And we got a whole car shop. A physical business where we've been making money for over a decade, okay? Like, it's crazy. Getting, in some cases, man, yo, Amazon, Walmart, boom, they just let you right on. Other cases, it takes you forever, all right? There's a couple instances where I know people have been trying to sign up with Walmart for the last, like, 6-7 months. It's a long-ass time, bro, long-ass time. Just to wait to get an account open and before you even list products and all this shit. So, with that, let's say you get on first try, right? There's a couple things with Walmart that I don't like at all. And it's pretty much, hey, we're just going to auto refund people. Like there's a lot of fraudulent activity going on the Walmart platform. And it's usually customer based. You know, it's people that, you know, they get the item and then they complain to Walmart and say, I never got it. Like, no, you got it because it was delivered. There was even a picture that was sent saying that they delivered it, but they say that they didn't, and then they automatically get refunded, and you know, it's a huge, huge deal. And there's a lot of that going on, okay? So before you even decide to jump in, just know that that's something that is going to be happening, and you gotta be willing to risk it, all right? There's a lot of fraudulent charges. I'd venture to say anywhere between 5 to 10% of your sales will be fraudulent. You know, maybe more than that. There, in some cases, there, depending on the item, there's more than that, especially if it's an expensive item. Chances are you're going to be in a 20 or 30% fraudulent charges just, you know, because the item is so expensive. And Walmart is pretty relaxed when it comes to like the burden of proof, when it comes to, you know, customers having to show them that they never received the item or that they received it broken or whatever else. Like, it's a pain in the ass. Also, the way that automation is being done, Walmart automation at least, is going from Amazon to Walmart. Okay, so if you guys were around back in the golden age of eBay, you know, I'm dating myself now, like, yeah, I'm an old ass dude at this point, at least by e-com standards. Back in the day, you could drop ship from Amazon onto the eBay platform. So people would find Amazon listings, create the listing on eBay, boom, sell it over there. And for a time, it was good. It's like Walmart automation is now. It was beautiful. Margins were high. I mean, you was making money hand over fist. But eBay got tired of that bullshit. eBay was like, what? Our customers are getting Amazon boxes? So they essentially shut down a whole method, right? That's why you don't see it anymore. People don't do that shit anymore because eBay shut that down. Amazon as well. Amazon started shutting down accounts that were drop shipping from Amazon to eBay. Okay. They were like, oh, you want to just abuse your buyer privileges? Okay. Boom, account shut down. And then, you know, you had to get like a sister or brother or mama or dad or neighbors, brothers, cousins, uncles, aunties, whatever. You know, it was just not a good time. So eBay shut that down. A lot of people lost a lot of money almost overnight. Okay. They were not feeling it. Walmart is still new and they're kind of enjoying people getting to the platform. What do you think happens when they get tired of that shit? When they get tired of their Walmart customers getting an Amazon package? What do you think is going to happen? They're going to shut that shit down. That's what's going to happen. And you're going to be left looking stupid as hell. Like, shit, I gave this Walmart automation company 40 grand of my money and now I'm shut down. What do I do? You know, I don't know. You figure it out with them. Also, suspensions. Like, it's weird because no one really knows all the ins and outs of Walmart yet to say, like, oh, your account is 100% safe, because suspensions do happen on a Walmart platform. I have not faced it myself personally, so I'm going to go ahead and put that out there. I'm good, you know, but I have seen, and it's weird because getting, like, you can come back. I feel that you can come back a little easier than Amazon right now because Walmart is just like, yo, we need to keep people on this platform because we're trying to grow. But like, no one kind of knows what like triggers that shit other than like certain metrics and stuff. But it's weird. Like, it's not something that I would be willing to invest in just yet. Okay. At least for me. Like, you know, you guys know I'm a safe bet. You know, when it comes to stocks, I'm like a blue chip type of guy. I'm not looking to make all the money today. I'm more of a long-term, you know, thought process. I tell all my clients, like, when they sign on for Amazon automation, it's long-term, baby. We're not here to just do high volume. It's long-term. We're looking for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 years worth of longevity to keep making the money over the long haul. You know, I'm that guy. I'm not near as risky when it comes to that type of stuff. Even though I did buy a $150,000 barbershop franchise during a pandemic, opened up in the cold, but that's whatever. Okay. So just know that Walmart automation is not without its caveats. You know, like I said, the margins are really, really high. Okay. But you know, you gotta be mindful because they're all going from like Amazon to Walmart, and that shit, it ain't gonna last forever. No matter what anybody says. We thought it was gonna last forever with eBay too. We was happy as hell. And then it got destroyed essentially, you know, and it changed everyone's businesses. So just be mindful of that. I mean, if you want to do Walmart automation, go right ahead. But for me, like I personally feel that I need another, you know, 6 months or so to see how it's going to go, to navigate it, because the whole Amazon and Walmart shit I'm not cool with that. I'm not cool with that at all. Like, but that's not what we do with our store. Like the Speed Circuit store, obviously, you know, we have wholesale distributors and stuff and it goes out and everything's just honky dory. But, you know, you still have to be mindful because a lot of guys are going from Amazon to Walmart just to make it easy on themselves because they don't have wholesale distributors and they're not going to take, you know, they're not going to build a time machine and go back, you know, 5 to 10 years to set those accounts up and all that shit. Like, they don't have the time now. They're like, yo, let's just go ahead and this is what works. You know, essentially the body slam and let's get the jamming, right? So whatever. I mean, people can do that and it is what it is. It's just also a smaller platform, so there's not near as many sellers, so that's why the margins are much higher, because you have the opportunity to just beat out so many other sellers. You know, but over time, as it becomes saturated, the margins will probably drop down, you know, and it'll kind of fall in line with Amazon. It really depends too. Now with Amazon automation, you guys probably know more about that. You know, I feel that it's a more steady platform. I wouldn't say necessarily safer. It's just more steady. It's been around longer and everyone knows Amazon. All right. Everyone shops on Amazon, you know, everybody, $1 trillion company. Okay. Everybody and their grandmas are shopping on Amazon. You know, the margins are a little bit lower just because there's more sellers, been around longer. You know, the methods are a little bit different, but I still feel that it's fairly safe. Now, the one thing I can say with Amazon, the metrics thing, man, like Amazon is a stickler for metrics and it's much more difficult to adhere to those metrics than it would be for the Walmart platform. I feel like it's a little bit easier on Walmart to keep things going. Whereas with Amazon, it's kind of a pain in the ass, though, to be honest with you guys. Like, that's what keeps me up most nights. is trying to make sure these metrics are good, or like, oh shit, the metrics slipped for this customer. Like, oh, we dropped down to a 92% valid tracking rate. Woo! You know, Amazon isn't happy about that. You know, I mean, it's not like the end of the world, but it's always, you know, trying to navigate it and make sure things are good. You know, it's a pain, guys. Like, that's just what it is. You know, the suspension process, I feel, takes a little bit longer, just because Amazon doesn't read everything. Humans don't read every single appeal. You know, usually a machine will scan through it, and then, you know, a secondary person will look and they'll mark it and like, we didn't see what we wanted. And like, nobody knows besides like baller ass appeals teams, which is why I have an appeal team that handles all that shit. They know what Amazon's looking for, but the average person doesn't necessarily know. Like, you can look on the seller forums and they'll tell you like, oh, they're looking for this and this and this and this and this. And even if you give them all that, they still say it's not enough information and that you need to try again. So after about 35, 40 appeals, boom, they reinstate you because you just changed up like four words somewhere in there. You know, it's weird, but that's just what it is with Amazon. Okay. It's not perfect. But it's a platform that I feel, you know, works for a lot of people as long as you keep certain things in mind. Now, when it comes to the whole margin thing, okay, 8 to 12% is generally what you're going to be seeing when it comes to like the dropshipping thing. When it comes to, comes to Walmart, you looking at like 20 to 35. That's a big jump, right? A big, big jump. And that's why people are, you know, jumping to the platform. That's why they're like, oh, Walmart automation, because the margins are insane. You know, that's why they got dudes like Nolan Johnson from NXJ Marketing out there essentially, you know, trying to suck people off to get them to sign up. You know, like this dude, I've heard a lot of, you know, the stuff from the marketing team. Not like, if you guys follow me on social media, shameless plug, you know, below, I called the dude out for not being able to sell, right? He flat out said he doesn't sell on Amazon. He don't know shit about it. You really think that this dude knows how to sell on Walmart now? He just magically started selling. Like, a lot of the guys in the space are switching from Amazon to Walmart dropshipping. All right, a lot of the big marketers. Why do you think that is? Because it's a shiny thing and they can take some screenshots before account gets shut down and they can put it out to you and be like, oh, we did 20 to 30% margins. Sounds great, doesn't it? Sounds amazing, doesn't it? So amazing that people will sign up and not even know what they're getting into. So with Walmart, I feel it's more of a risk. So if you're willing to risk all that and essentially come out with zero, Walmart automation is the way to go right now. If you're willing to risk it for the biscuit and be like, yo, if my money goes in here and it just drops to zero, I'm cool with it. I lose all whatever they're charging, 35, 40, 50 grand, some shit like that, I don't know. But whatever it is, if it's 35 grand, I'm willing to lose all $35,000. If you're willing to do that, Walmart automation is for you, okay? It's for you. If you're not, then Amazon's probably a safer play. Even though the margins aren't as high, the longevity is there that I feel. And until Walmart has a little bit more time in the spotlight, I don't think that it's ready for most people. For people like me, it's fucking prime. I'll lose my money. I'm cool with that. But the average person who's trying to get involved in that and build some form of passive income, they ain't ready for that. They're not ready, okay? Like, y'all need to smash that like button, first off. But do your research, too. You guys need to do your research and make sure that you're set, okay? So I don't want to see anybody get clubbed over the head, because I get tons of DMs all the time. And now that, you know, I don't have near as much time as I used to, you know, I can't help everybody. But, you know, I do see a lot of them, and I see a lot of you out there. You're like, oh, man, this guy, you know, he said, you know, Walmart automation, and he said, you know, Amazon FBA, you know, wholesale automation, and, you know, I gave this dude, you know, $60,000, and they didn't do anything, or this part. And, like, I see it, guys. And, like, that's why I make the videos. Like, because realistically, like, I don't care if, you know, the guys in the space hate me. Like, I have my friends, and, you know, I trust them, and I know they do right for their clients, and I do right by my clients, so I'm cool with that. For the people that don't like me, it's because they fucking suck and they know that they're doing things wrong. And if you think for a second that I'm gonna stop, you know, making videos to educate you guys about it, you know, they can suck a whole bag of donkey wieners. Like, I don't care. You know, what are they gonna do, fly to Philly and try to fight me? Bro, I'm out here in Kensington in Junkie Central with a trap house down the street. These dudes piss themselves before they even step foot off the plane. They couldn't even come into Kensington without getting beat the fuck up, right? So You know, like that's why I can do that for you guys. And I just want everybody to make sure that, you know, you guys make informed decisions and that you're safe when you make those decisions, because, you know, it's a lot of money, right? A lot of people are taking out loans. They're liquidating credit cards. They're, you know, selling off stocks. I mean, doing crazy things in order to make some passive income. And if that's you, I just want to make sure that you guys, that you understand what you're getting yourself into. Okay. So just be really, really careful. So now you know, Walmart automation, Amazon automation, pick your poison. Obviously, you know, I'm Amazon biased, but I do sell on Walmart. So, I mean, I have the experience now and it ain't ready for prime time. So with that being said, man, check out the links below in the description. You guys can hit me up on social, you know, hit me up on IG. I'm always, you know, available. You know, I try to help you guys out as best I can. But like I said, you know, I'm busy these days, you know, running all these businesses and handling all my clients and stuff. And, you know, but hey, I still try to make time for you. So be safe, be smart. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.